Hello, I am Melissa with Medical English Melissa. I'm a nurse practitioner and a midwife from the United States, and I'm also a TEFL certified English teacher. And this is Medical English 5-Minute Clinic. So in the next 5 minutes, I will give you as many helpful phrases and tips as possible to build upon the English that you already have and use it to communicate with colleagues and patients in a clinical setting. And I'll cover a lot of information pretty quickly, but there is an accompanying free study guide that you can download, and you just have to go to the tab that says resources, the link that says resources below, and then you can get it for free. And I'll go more in depth there and explain things that were maybe too quick during this. Okay, so let's get into it. Today I am talking about how to take a patient history with headaches. And you can't talk about headaches without talking about pain. So I'll be talking about headaches and pain. By the way, if you have an idea of something you'd like me to talk about in future episodes, you can comment below and I'll see what people are interested in. In the US, clinicians are taught a mnemonic when they're in school, and it is old CARTS.
O is onset, L is location, D is duration, C is characteristics, A is either associated symptoms or aggravating factors, R is relieving factors, T is timing, and S is severity.
So, onset. How long have you been experiencing these headaches? When did you first start getting these headaches? These are all ways that you can ask this question. Next, location. Where do you get your headaches? Where on your head do you feel your headache? Where is your headache located? You can ask, which side of your head do you get the headache? Is it one-sided or both sides? Do you feel it around your face? Do you get the headache around your forehead? These are all different ways that you can ask. And there's a lot more that you might get with responses, but there isn't quite enough time for that, so I will put that in the study guide. D, duration. How long do your headaches usually last? How long does it take for the headache to go away? Another helpful phrase is, does it come and go or is it persistent? Does it come in waves or is it persistent? Meaning, does it come and go away or is it a persistent headache? Just lasting throughout. C, characteristics. There are a lot of different ways to describe a headache. I will get into some of them. You can ask a patient, is it more of a sharp shooting pain or is it a dull aching pain? Sharp shooting is just a collocation. We always seem to use those words together, sharp shooting pain. You would also say, is it a stabbing pain or is it a throbbing, pulsating pain? There are a lot of different ways you can ask about this. A, let's add associated symptoms here because there's a lot that could come along with a headache. Do you feel nauseated when you get the headache? Do you experience nausea when you get the headache? Do you have nausea when you get the headache? Do you become nauseated or throw up before or during your headaches? Do you have any visual disturbances? You can ask a patient if they get an aura before a headache, but they might not know what that means. So you can talk about having floaters and having blind spots in your vision. Are you sensitive to light before or during your headache? Are you sensitive to smell before or during your headache? Do certain smells bother you? Do you experience any dizziness or lightheadedness? And there's a lot more here and you'll find them in the study guide. A is also aggravating factors. Is there anything that makes it worse? Have you noticed anything makes it worse? Both are fine to say. Have you noticed that anything triggers the headache? R, relieving factors. Have you tried anything for pain? Have you tried taking anything for your headache? This is a way to ask about medication. Is there anything that makes it better? Is there anything that alleviates the pain? T, timing. Have you noticed that the headache comes at a certain time of day, a certain time of month? And S, severity. So you can ask, on a scale of 0 to 10, 10 being the worst pain you've ever had and 0 being no pain, how bad is your pain? How bad is your headache? By the way, a really helpful phrase to know is the worst headache of my life. And I don't have time to talk about stroke symptoms in this episode, but it's a good phrase to know because in English, that's how we often describe someone talking about stroke symptoms or one of the stroke symptoms. So the worst headache of my life or the worst headache I've ever had. And that's all for today. In next week's episode, at the request of some students, I'll be talking about verbs around vital signs. So to lower, to drop, to raise, to crash, to stabilize, and more. In the meantime, if you want to ask me any questions, you can find me on all of these social media options, or you can just message me in the comments or on my website. And I'll see you here next week for Medical English 5-Minute Clinic.